Kenya, that is TASC, has been discussing issues in the industry, including the current and upcoming changes across the industry, where actuaries work on how skills could be used to help solve current industry bottlenecks. Now, the conference dubbed Breaking Boundaries, ending today, brings together qualified and trained actuaries in promoting the actuarial profession in Kenya and East Africa. I'm now joined in studio by Ezekiel Macharia, the manager director of Ken Bright and also a member of TASC, or the Actuarial Society of Kenya, to shed more light on the ongoing deliberations in this industry. And I'll just walk straight up to him. Thank you very much, Ezekiel, and you're welcome to Inside Business.
Thank you very much.
Now, for the benefit of, I believe, most of our viewers who are watching right now, bring us to speed. When we're talking about actuaries, what profession, what kind of profession is this?
Okay, thank you very much for having me. An actuary is a business profession whose role is measurement and management of risk. Mm-hmm. In the same way you see as an engineer, as a person who builds a bridge and makes sure that the bridge is safe for people, the actuary's work is to design financial products, mm-hmm. and manage the risk therein. Mm-hmm. So that means that they look at the capital that a company has and sees whether that money is enough to sustain the business. Mm-hmm.
Now, we've just been talking to my colleague on issues on financial inclusion. Yeah. And we're just wondering, looking at the Kenyan space, what are some of the interventions TASC has been able to put across to help solve these issues that we see on a daily basis?
Now, what TASC does, TASC is the Actuarial Society of Kenya. Mm-hmm. And one thing to note is that the number of actuaries in Kenya has been very small. Mm-hmm. And in fact, in Kenya, we only have 35 actuaries, as opposed to globally, where in places like London or New York, where we have 10,000 actuaries. So for us, what we're trying to do is we're trying to share skills, share knowledge with our partners from other markets to come to Kenya and show us things about to deal with, like IFRS, things to do with banking regulations, insurance regulations, and other things of how actuaries can support mm-hmm. the industry. Mm-hmm. Now, I saw in the previous article you talked about, two-thirds of Kenyans don't have formal access to financial services. Mm-hmm. Now, one thing to note is that Kenya is very strong in things like M-Pesa. Now, if we grow the actuarial profession, we are able to come in and use the technology we have, like M-Pesa, to create financial inclusion. Mm-hmm. So the actuaries are the ones who do that, so who support the financial institutions that we have. Mm-hmm.
Now let's talk about the convention that is ongoing currently. What are some of the issues that you're seeking to address in the two-day event?
Okay, so for the convention, there are a number of items we're looking at. One, we're looking at launching the Actuarial Academy, and what that means is that we're trying to bridge the gap between the academia and the professional world. So we have about 1,000 students entering the actuarial profession, rather the BSc actuary in the universities, but we only have 35 actuaries who are fully qualified. So the academy will try to bridge that gap, mm-hmm. and make sure we have more fully qualified actuaries. Mm-hmm. The second one will be to talk about breaking boundaries, which is traditionally actuaries have worked in the insurance sector. Those skills can be used to support the banking industry and the capital market industry, especially when we're dealing with things like derivatives and other things. After the financial crisis happened, the financial sector is getting more complex, so we are trying to get those skills now so that we can support our own markets, mm-hmm. as we move forward.
And maybe for argument's sake, if you're a young person out there, or possibly a young person out there, yeah. Is looking to be part of this profession, yeah. They're thinking of what areas to pursue, what would you advise the people that are listening to you now?
What I'd advise you is actuarial is a very good profession, and if you look at just the university, the actuarial science is actually in line with the medical degree in terms of the points that the person should have. And if you're strong in math and you're strong in statistics and you're interested in business and financial services, actuarial is a very good profession for you, that's one. Secondly, it's very marketable, not just in Kenya, but outside. Mm-hmm. And you'll find there's a lot of need for risk management, especially the financial sectors, mm-hmm. Globally. So if a student is very interested in joining the Actuarial Society, we are open to all Kenyans. People can join us. We do take in direct subscriptions or through the universities. And we have about 20 universities that are members of the Actuarial Society.
Mm-hmm. Now, you mentioned 35 being the only ones that are fully qualified within the Kenyan space.
Yeah.
And we're looking at thousands that join the profession at a learning level every year. So then what explains this gap? Where do the 900 plus go?
It's actually not just a Kenya phenomenon. It's actually a global phenomenon where you find there are many people who join the actuarial profession, but very few pass.
Mm-hmm.
And for us, we are trying to bridge that gap. And that's why we do hold conferences like the we are doing today.
Mm-hmm.
We are talking about the Actuarial Academy. But the key thing is to note is that for us to achieve those qualification criteria, once the actuaries qualify, like us now and myself, we try and now go back and support the student body to come up and also increase the numbers of actuaries.
And maybe you may want to tell us, what are some of these initiatives that you pursue, what programs, what mentorship programs or trainings that we will be seeing in the academy that you're looking to bring on?
Okay, so one of the things will be professionalism in terms of what is the role of the student once they become an actuary, because traditionally, for example, the actuary is the one who deals with pensions, for example, where he says how much should the pensioners get an increase, or is the money in the pension fund enough? So professionalism is very important in terms of what you write is what should go. So that is one. Secondly, is research. Research, that means data collection. It means finding out what are the things for Africa or for Kenya that we need so that we get the right answers. And thirdly, it will be mentorship of the upcoming students and telling them what are the key areas to focus on. For example, one of the key areas is data science.
Mm-hmm.
We are moving more digital, so how do we support the students to get skills that are relevant? We are talking about laptops today being launched. So if the people who are coming up, the young generation, I would say maybe somebody who's 10 years old, they need to compete when they're 25 or 30. So for us, we're trying to also provide knowledge that is relevant to them.
Mm-hmm.